Hi, welcome back to my nursery. I'm here today to show you how to grow some beautiful Drosera Binata, the forked-leaf sundew. These guys are native to New Zealand and Australia, and they are an absolutely awesome and easy to grow plant for anyone who's trying to get into carnivorous plants. Let's go in depth.
Drosera Binata is a member of the order Caryophyllales, family Droseraceae, genus Drosera, subgenus Phycopsis. They grow in both New Zealand and Southeast Australia and are quite prolific throughout. They also have all kinds of different synonyms that I've put on screen here, such as Drosera dichotoma, which I've been sold as one before. Charles Darwin studied the species and it was one of the plants he used in his 1875 insectivorous plants. Now, Drosera binata likes 1-to-1 peat to perlite for its soil. It enjoys to be always wet, tray watered, enjoys weekly fertilization, as much light as you can give it. Dormancy, yes, it can go dormant if it's treated like a temperate plant and forms a hibernaculum, and can be grown year-round as a tropical. They're very easy to grow and are very hardy. Now, on to propagation. They vigorously reproduce from leaf cuttings in water after about a month. As you can see here in the video, I am clipping, snipping, putting it into a plastic container. Make sure you get it all the way in there. The forked leaves make it a little bit difficult sometimes. Put some water, and you don't want to flood the plant out. You want to just get enough in there to where it's covered. And there you go. Looks good. Cap it off. And within about a month, you will see little plantlets start forming. Those little plantlets will look like this, and you can transplant them into some peat moss and perlite and get them growing in some very humid conditions. I grow mine under a humidity dome. And then within about another month from that, you will have a tray like this, so you can easily divide them out, and they will start growing roots and get nice and large and look absolutely beautiful for you. You can expect them to take about a year to get to flower, and I really haven't tried growing these from seed to be able to comment on the difficulty for it. They've just grown so well for me from cuttings.
All right, so to recap, this is a tropical sundew that grows in both New Zealand and Australia, requires very wet and damp soils. It can appreciate very tropical weather, but can also handle temperate freezes as well, as it can go into a dormant state, and is incredibly easy to propagate. I highly recommend this for any beginner who's trying to look into getting into sundews, and I hope that you found this guide interesting and helpful. If you want to see more like this, please like and subscribe. If you have any more questions on how to grow these plants, please leave a comment below and I'll definitely get back to you. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a great day.